That's what it is.
Something like that. So, yeah.
Is that what you do?
But also so that they can establish, are they okay with other dogs, so they're potentially purchasing dogs that they want to report to other dog owners too. So that's one. Two is to see if they can have any behavioral issues with other dogs, like do they correct appropriately, do they keep corrections appropriately. And then it's also to establish a place by it. So, like these two would be probably rough and rowdy from what I've seen of them. But they have rough and rowdy, they have, push and pull, which is when a dog comes up and like gets up into a dog's face and then as that dog starts to respond, like they run.
That's what my dog used to do.
Yeah, so they want to chase them. So that's a push and pull play style. And then there's like the gentle and nice where they kind of just play out to each other and maybe just gently play and they're not really obnoxious.
Oh, okay.
And then there's the ones that just are called just, they just keep to themselves. Like they don't really care if you play games. There's several different things. And then once they have that information, then when they do the actual larger playgroup, so when they do the evaluations, it's set up with like usually 2 to 4 healthy dogs. And so those are dogs that have done this before and that they have a lot of information on. And they'll set up the dog that's coming up to they'll do dog and then they'll do the then they bring the dogs that meet those criteria. So like if they have a rough and rowdy play group, then they only bring rough and rowdy dogs. So that they're setting up the play group. So they can technically be a rough and rowdy dog. I was standing up there and I was watching one of them. And it was kind of like, well, kind of just obnoxious. And it was the coolest thing because he stopped me, looked around the yard, and was like, nobody likes when I do this. So they took one of those dogs out, they brought another dog in, and he ran up to him and was like, hey, let's be friends. And he came and he's like, he met every dog in the gate and like brought them in and kind of introduced them. And he just took a different dog after that. And he was adopted like 2 days later. And they followed up with him because they really wanted to see how. For me, that was all I needed to see on playgroups. Like, they've been talking about how beneficial they were in other ways, and I saw that. They also find some dogs, they discover their dog has significant pain issues because they start trying to find their meds. So now they have coyote rollers on the top of all the coyote.
What's up?
But these are things that they post to the dog in the hospital about.
No, 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 no. Good boy. Good boy.
Good job, Ari.
Good boy.
I don't know. I think just his sheer size, just being big, I think scares people. Yeah, well, me too. But I think that's a lot of people come in because I hear that a lot when people are walking. He's huge. He's tall, but he's not a huge dog.
I mean, he's like.
Right, right. What are you doing? You were such a good boy. I saw you. I saw you. Yeah, I did. Oh, thank you. You hit me in the mouth. Nice. Yeah, that was nice.
Okay.